Welcome to this brief guide on how to use linked slides in Google Slides. Have you been looking for a way to keep your audience engaged when you're making your presentation? Well, how about letting them choose the order of the presentation? Today, I'm going to show you how to use linked slides to make that a reality. Here you can see I have my mythical West Coast road trip, and I'm looking to show off some of the photos from my trip. Now I've got a list of my destinations. I've visited Long Beach, I've checked out the sunset in Malibu, and I've gone on a Pacific Coast highway adventure. But if I'd like to let the audience decide in which order we're going to look at these photos in, I need a way to jump around my slides at will. So what I noticed here on my side, I have slides 3, 5, and 7, which are the locations for the beginning of each of those different sections of my photos. So what we need to do is head back to slide 2, and we're going to use the text boxes for each of the different destinations and link them to the appropriate slides. To do so, we simply right click on one of our text boxes, and in the context menu, we select the option that says link. This is going to give us a pop-up in the middle of our screen where we have default options for next slide and first slide, or we can use the search box up the top there where we can paste in any link we'd like. For instance, it could be a YouTube URL, or even a Google Doc or a Google Sheet if you wish. The option that we're going to utilize in this instance though is the option right down the bottom here that tells us that we can use slides in this presentation, at which point we get a list of all of the different slides that we have. And just to confirm to make sure we've got the right one for Malibu Sunset, I can check to make sure, yep, Malibu Sunset is slide number 5. And so I can head back over to my pop-up and I can select slide 5. I will know that I've got the correct one because I will see a link to it right there. I also have buttons here where I can edit the link if I need to, or remove the link if I wish to take it away from this particular text box. Now that I've got that section set, we need to do a couple of little things in order for us to get back from the Malibu Sunset photos back over to our slide 2 so that we can go to the next destination. But when I right click on, say for instance, one of these photos, I don't have a link option in the context menu. So instead, I'm actually going to use a sneaky little trick, which is the keyboard shortcut Control K when I have the photo selected, which will still give me that link option even though it wasn't available to me in the context menu. And so now I simply link this photo to slide number 2, which gets me back to my destinations menu page, which once I've got this set up, we can then go and check and see how this is going to look in our actual presentation itself. Now to do that, we're going to head back to slide 1 and we'll begin our slideshow using the slideshow button or the keyboard shortcut Control F5. And then from the second slide, you'll see that I can click on the words Malibu Sunset and it jumps me straight over to slide 5. And then from slide 6, my hidden button in the top corner here takes me back to slide 2. Now this is great and all, but there's a bit of a problem here. How do I manage to get to the final slide if everything is going to be bringing me back to slide number 2? I could choose to link maybe this destination's text box to the last slide in my presentation, but instead, we're going to do something a little bit more fancy and we're going to make an invisible button. To do so, we select the text box option in our toolbar, and what we can do anywhere on any slide we'd like, we can simply just create a text box, and instead of typing anything into it, we simply link this text box to the last slide in our presentation, essentially making ourselves an invisible button on our slides. Now, let's see how that's going to look by initiating our slideshow. And here we have my slides, and I have my buttons that would take me to the Long Beach, Malibu Sunset, and Pacific Coast sections of my slides. But in the top corner, I have a hidden link, which if I click on this one, is going to take me straight over to my final slide, which is my lovely little thank you slide at the end of my presentation. This is a great way to keep your audience interacting and engaged in your future presentations. And that is how you use linked slides in Google Slides. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your presentation just that much more engaging in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.